Hello, and welcome to the Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on determining empirical and molecular formulas. First of all, what's the difference between an empirical and a molecular formula? The empirical formula is the formula that indicates the number and types of atoms in a molecule in their lowest ratio, or the simplest formula. The molecular formula is the formula that indicates the actual number and types of atoms in a molecule. So the empirical formula can always be determined from the molecular formula, but the molecular formula can't always be determined from the empirical formula. Let's look at an example of how to determine an empirical formula given the percent composition of a substance. You have a compound that is 54.52% carbon, 9.17% hydrogen, and 36.31% oxygen by weight. Determine the empirical formula. The first step when starting these problems is to assume that you have a 100 gram sample. You can actually assume that you have any sample size that you want, but if you assume that you have a 100 gram sample, that means that of that 100 gram sample, 54.52 grams are carbon, 9.17 grams are hydrogen, and 36.31 grams are oxygen. So assuming a 100 gram sample allows for an easy conversion of percent by weight to grams. The next step is to convert the number of grams of each of the elements to moles, and we do that using the molar mass. Remember, the molar mass can be found on your periodic table. Remember, you can determine the molar mass by looking at your periodic table. And this is because formulas are written in terms of atoms or moles. They're not written in terms of grams. So we convert the grams of carbon, grams of hydrogen, and grams of oxygen to moles using their respective molar masses to give us 4.54 moles of carbon per every 9.08 moles of hydrogen per every 2.27 moles of oxygen. Now we can't stop here because you can't write a formula that's C with the subscript 4.54, H with the subscript 9.08, and O with the subscript 2.27. You need to have subscripts in your formulas that are whole numbers. And so to do that, we're going to divide all of our moles by the smallest number of moles to get our smallest whole number ratio. So in this example, 2.27 moles is the smallest number of moles that we have, and so we'll divide all of these values by 2.27. That gives us a whole number ratio of 2 moles of carbon per 4 moles of hydrogen per 1 mole of oxygen. And the last step is to check to see that you have a whole number ratio. So sometimes, even after you divide by the smallest number of moles, you still won't have a whole number ratio, and you might need to then multiply your mole ratio by a different number to give you the smallest whole number ratio. So for example, if in this case we had 2 moles of carbon per 4.5 moles of hydrogen per 1 mole of oxygen, then multiplying all of those values by 2 would give us whole number ratios. But because we already have a whole number ratio, we've now determined the empirical formula of our compound, which is C2H4O. But what if you're asked to determine the molecular formula? Well, you can't determine the molecular formula from a percent composition analysis unless you are given additional information. You need to be given the molecular weight of your compound, and you can use this information and the previously determined empirical formula to then calculate your molecular formula. So if the molecular weight of our unknown compound was 88.1 AMUs, we can compare that to the molecular weight of the empirical formula. Remember, the empirical formula is just the formula of a compound in the lowest whole number ratio. And so in this case, the molecular weight of our empirical formula is 44.06 AMUs. And what you'll notice is that the molecular weight of the unknown compound is twice the molecular weight of the empirical formula. That means that the molecular formula must be twice that of the empirical formula. So if I multiplied the molecular weight of the empirical formula by 2, that would give me the molecular weight of the unknown compound, which was given to us in the problem. That means that we need to multiply the empirical formula by 2, giving us the molecular formula of C4H8O2. Let's try another example. Oxalic acid is composed of 26.68% carbon, 2.24% hydrogen, and 71.08% oxygen by mass, and has a molecular weight of 90.04 amu. What are the empirical and molecular formulas? Again, the first step is to assume a 100-gram sample. So if you have a 100-gram sample and 26.68% of that sample is carbon, that means that you have 26.68 grams of carbon. And likewise, if 2.24% of that 100-gram sample is hydrogen, that means you have 2.24 grams of hydrogen. And if 71.08% of that sample is oxygen, then you have 71.08 grams of oxygen. The next step is to convert the grams of each of the elements to moles using the molar mass, which you can find again on the periodic table. This gives us a ratio of 2.22 moles of carbon per 2.22 moles of hydrogen per 4.44 moles of oxygen. In order to get the smallest whole number, we'll divide by the smallest number of moles. So in this case, we'll divide by 2.22. This tells us that for every 1 mole of carbon in the compound, there is 1 mole of hydrogen and 2 moles of oxygen in the compound. And now again, check to see that you have a whole number ratio, and if not, multiply your values to obtain the smallest whole number ratio possible. This gives us an empirical formula of CHO2. Now to determine the molecular formula, we'll compare the given molecular weight of oxalic acid and the previously determined empirical formula. We were given that the molecular weight of oxalic acid is 90.04 amu. The molecular weight of our empirical formula we can determine to be 45.02 amu. And again, it turned out that the molecular weight of the unknown compound was twice that of the molecular weight of the empirical formula, which means that the molecular formula must be twice that of the empirical formula. And now it just so happens that in each of these examples, the molecular formula turned out to be twice that of the empirical formula. That's not always the case. Sometimes your empirical and molecular formulas are the same. Sometimes your molecular formulas are 3 times the empirical formula. But all you need to do is to compare your molecular weights and figure out how many times the molecular formula is that of the empirical formula. And then you know what to multiply your empirical formula by to get the molecular formula. Thanks for watching The Chemistry Solution. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial.